Power Stick. Power Stick offers more odor fighters than ever before. By Corel Corporation, makers of Corel Draw, the world's best graphic software. And by Rado Swiss Watches. Why just tell time when you can express it? We'll be back with today's final right after this. And here is how Jimmy Connors got to the final this week.
Well, Connors really has played convincing tennis throughout, and it's a big win over Jose Luis Clerc, who came in playing very well, especially after Clerc had just beaten Guillermo Vilas. So Connors has come through convincingly, unlike Westchester, where he had mostly three setters. This week he's been winning in straight sets.
Jimmy Connors just a few weeks short of his 42nd birthday. 5'10", 155 pounds. Born in Belleville, Illinois. Resides there half the year. Attended college at UCLA. And what about him? Five straight victories on the Champions Tour. Is this the week where he gives it up?
Well, I think he's going to have a tough match today with Borg. I think conditions favor Borg. It's windy, like I said earlier, and it's swirly. The court's a little slower than last week.
You talk about how Borg plays is really going to be a factor. Jimmy Connors always plays at a very high level. And I think it's going to be key for Borg to keep the ball deep in the court. I think in Westchester, Borg's balls were falling very short. And when Connors was playing in the middle of the court with that knife of a backhand, he really can hurt you. And that was really causing a lot of problems for Borg last week. So if this great Swedish champion can keep the ball deep in the court, I think his chances are going to be better than ever.
Let's look at the bottom half of the draw to see how Bjorn Borg made his way to the final.
Borg convincingly into the finals. He beat Johan Kriek, who's been playing very well in the semifinals. Defeated Dick Stockton, and actually Dick Stockton was telling me after the match he was hoping he could get points in the second set. Borg played so well. So obviously Borg getting better with each week.
I think he won 13 straight points in one time, and when Stockton finally won a point, he went down on his knees, a la Borg at Wimbledon. So it was a great, amusing moment. I'm sure Stockton was relieved that he'd finally gotten a point.
Borg, 38 years old, 5'11", 185, 165. He's not moving like he's 38 years old, from Södertälje, Sweden, one of my Swedish countrymen. And he really has, each week, brought his game up to a new level. And last week in Westchester, I mean, he really could have broken through. I'm wondering if this is the week.
Well, you know, you can practice all you want. Go out on the practice court and hit tons of balls out of a basket. But when you're playing matches, there's nothing that can replace that. And he's emphasized that you know, you get into that match rhythm. And really, it's a mental thing in a way for him, too. Because he starts feeling more confident about playing the big points, his shots begin to fall in.
Well, he's had the problem that a lot of players, when they stop playing, they have to think when they're doing it out there. And Bjorn told me earlier in the week, he said, you know, now I'm beginning to react to these tough points. I don't think, and when I react, that's when I play my best.
Let's look at these great players' record against each other, and I think no matter who Borg has played in his career, he has an advantage. Borg 10-7 in the regular ATP events, including several Grand Slam events, Wimbledon most notable among those. But Connors is 3-0 versus Borg on the Champions Tour. As we've mentioned, Connors, the winner of all five of the previous Champions Tour stops, most recently last week in New York. Our umpire is Dave Radosha from Walpole, Massachusetts. They've taken their warm-up serves. We're just about ready for this final to get underway.
And I bet Dave is feeling a bit relieved that this isn't a tour event. You know, it's a very relaxed atmosphere. Although these guys try 100%, it just doesn't have the tension of, you know, arguing over line calls. These guys play in a very gentlemanly fashion.
Connors winning the toss, elects to receive on the east end of the court that has the wind blowing in his face.
Second.
And without the wind, that might have been a decent lob, but that'll show you how much these gusting winds, as much as 15 to 20 miles per hour, are affecting the flight of the ball.
This is about a 3-club wind today.
Jimmy's telling Bjorn to club it up, 3 clubs on the wind today. And ace number
hit the line, and boy, these clay court lines, if you hit the line, it skids. It goes so fast.
Single shot in tennis, he really does so much with it. But again, that short ball in the middle of the court, Connors makes no mistake on those. Don't waste any time, do they?
Well, you seldom see Borg at the net unless it's to shake hands, and he guesses the wrong way here on the volley, makes a good stab at it. 30 all, first game.
Break point against Borg's serve here in the first game.
Well, that shot was a good example of how the wind can affect a ball that carried just long with a little bit of wind behind it.
Ace number two for Borg to get himself out of that little hole. Back to deuce.
Establishing his rhythm from the backcourt. Didn't make many errors yesterday against Clerc.
Interesting tactic in the first game. Borg's been to the net, half, 50% of the points. What do you think, Lee?
Well, I think it's a good play in some respects. I know that when we saw him playing Westchester, he was attacking Connors regularly and having some success with it. When he won that first set in last week's final, he did it by winning a lot of points at the net.
Connors versus Borg head-to-head by surfaces, and Connors has the edge on clay, tied on hard court. Borg ahead 3-2 on carpet, and Borg 4-0 on grass. But Borg 10-7 advantage on the ATP Tour. Of course, this hard true court is designed to be very much like the European clay, and it has some different characteristics that you, Coach Ralston, think actually favor Borg.
Well, I was surprised to see that. I didn't realize that Jimmy's beaten him twice in play. And, I would have picked it the other way around. That would have picked Jimmy to win on grass. Of course, my picks are always wrong.
15 love.
Thank you.
fortunate that we have these gusty, windy conditions. It is a component that is going to probably figure unduly in this match.
See, both players are taking some time, and they sense that wind is affecting their shots a bit, so they're really having to make the adjustment. We look at the new MTV star, Mr. Tony Bennett, enjoying the tennis here in Cape Cod. What a wonderful day we have.
He's quite a tennis player. He's played well. Play.
Authoritative volley by Borg.
15
love. Nice number three for Borg on what is probably the tougher side to serve on with the wind in the face, blowing the toss all over the place. You can hear it gusting in our microphones. Fault number one for Bjorn Borg.
Too often on the regular tour.
Like never.
Bjorn missed that first serve on purpose.
Good job.
That ball pounded at an angle off the clay here. Of course, this hard true court is made from greenstone, which is a stone found in Pennsylvania. It's nice drop volley from Bjorn Borg. Borg with a beautiful first serve. Notice the toss very high. Beautiful knee bend, and he gets a lot of his power through his legs.
What I like about his serve leap, it's so smooth, everything's together, balance is terrific, and that's why he has a great serve.
So Borg wins game number three. They're on service. Borg leading 2-1. Look at the way that Connors and Borg have dominated the major Grand Slam events from 1974 to 1983. Connors never winning a French Open, and Borg never winning an Australian or a U.S., but their names on those trophies many, many times.
Borg with a nice approach shot, hitting it behind Connors. A nice angle volley to finish the point off. And Connor's recovery, and notice the slide on the clay.
They're on serve here in the first set. Borg leading 2-1.
Thank you.
the one-hander hit with underspin. You don't see that a lot, but it's a good tactic against Jimmy because oftentimes his topspin will sit up high and Connors can hit the ball flat down into the court. But that one-handed underspin, he keeps the ball low so Connors can't drive it.
Watch this. It's just too good. Just kidding, of course. 15-30. Yeah.
It's so hard to find an opening. Jimmy Connors closes the door with this passing shot.
Oh, please.
Moves on the run so well and creates stuff when they're in trouble. Good preparation on that passing shot, Dennis. You get the racket back.
It's one thing the viewers can really pick up on is when you're going to hit a passing shot, get back. Wait till they get there.
The sooner you prepare for a shot, you know, the more options you're going to give yourself. But if you're setting up and trying to do something at the last second, you can't do as much with it. More chance for error. Both these guys, great footwork, great preparation, especially from the backcourt from Bjorn Borg.
And ace number one for Jimmy Connors.
Connors has served beautifully all week, and I think one of the reasons why is his new racket. He's very happy with this new single beam construction that he has, and he said that since the T2000 he's never had a racket that had as much trampoline, and this one, he says, really gives him a lot of power. We can see that on his first serve, but also on his second serve.
Well, he's hitting the ball harder. Also, the ball's jumping more spin.
He was saying yesterday if he had had one of these rackets 5 years ago, he'd still be out on the tour doing some damage.
A lot of guys are happy with it. Something on the side.
Well, that is a great tactic, and oftentimes it really puts the volleyer in a position to do something. Who's going to create the angle first? I think Borg's volleys have improved. A couple seasons of world team tennis under his belt where he's forced to play doubles every night. I think he's underrated his play at the net.
Comes in on a pretty short ball here, so he's just hoping to guess right, and he actually went the right way, but the shot was too good.
Oh. I think Borg will take that one.
As a gift.
You don't get many easy ones against Connors.
I think he just was kind of confused which way that ball was going to bounce and ran around to hit a forehand when he should have hit that backhand.
So we stay on serve. Borg leading 3-2 in the middle of this first set at the Medident Champions.
And here we see a comparison of the two forehands, distinctly different. Bjorn Borg, with the heavy topspin, hits the racket underneath the ball, a lot of loop with the wrist, turns over it. Tremendous amount of topspin, the ball bounces very high. Whereas when you watch the Connors forehand, more of a straight take back, and he hits almost every forehand flat or even with a little slice, a little underspin. Both different styles, both great balance, and both great shots.
On serve here in the first set, excuse me, Lee, 4-3 in favor of Borg. Connor serving to the wind.
Well, in some respects, they really reflect their game style as well. You know, Borg grew up on clay. There's a real premium on just keeping the ball in clay. And of course, Connors grew up on hard court. There's a real premium on hitting the ball hard and fast through the court. To drive that forehand, he just takes a little of that spin off it, puts his racket through it a bit more. That's what's so dangerous about Borg's forehand. One could be a loop, but the next one could be a hammer.
I think Jimmy looks a little tired, Lee. What do you think?
He's had a busy week. He had a doubles match late last night. I think we saw that he got a slow start in the Westchester final as well. So if he is feeling fatigued, he'd certainly be in his best interest to get this first set in his pocket.
Jimmy really credited the rain delay to his victory. It allowed him 4 hours to get his act together and conserve some of his strength. He came back one set down to defeat Borg in 6-4 in the third.
What a great approach shot by Bjorn Borg. Set up by two big forehands. And in this particular point, he wrong foots Jimmy on this next shot. Jimmy's looking for the backhand. Cross court to the forehand by Borg. Inside out forehand.
That was a tricky shot too, because it was very low in the middle of the court.
Tough shot to make.
Gusting during that point now. Here are the winners. Borg 13, winners to Connors 7. And Borg has his first break point against Connors serve here in the 8th game.
He's really taking advantage of that wind behind him now. Really pushing Connors way deep in the court.
First set on his racket, leading 5-3. He took the first set from Jimmy last week at Westchester. In fact, every one of Jimmy's opponents in the quarter, semis, and finals took the first set from him, which probably led to some of his fatigue in the final. He has gotten to this point by winning in straight sets, rather convincingly. But all it takes is a few of those points running around with Borg to tire out anyone.
Well, also, Dwight, it's, you know, it's tournament after tournament takes its toll, too, particularly if you're winning and it's Jimmy's tour. There's a lot of outside things that he's got to do.
And we'll be doing it all again next week in Columbus, Ohio. Seventh stop on this inaugural Champions Tour season. It went really gusting now, making shots very, very difficult for these two players. It's whipping those trees around pretty good. Capacity crowd once again, as we've seen in all the tour stops to this point. Bullet of a backhand by Borg. We're just all wincing up here.
That's an unbelievable shot, I tell you, because Connors just nailed the return, and then Borg hit it back even harder.
Triple set point for Borg.
Taking a page from Connor's book there. Lots of flat drives. Moving Connor's around pretty good. Very close to the baseline. It looks like it might have hit right on.
Well, Jimmy's not saying anything, and obviously he thinks the ball hit the line. There's an overrule here. Hard to tell from where we are. Great camera angle there, and the ball looked good to me.
Oftentimes when the ball hits those lines, you can hear it. It's a skidding sound. That's a nylon tape that's nailed down onto this greenstone surface.
Umpire Dave Radosha playing it as a let, so still two set points for.
Borg needs to be a little careful here. You know. Second set point that he's let get away, and there's a weakness in Borg. Sometimes he plays a little bit quickly against Connors. You don't want to give him any free points.
Connor's pushing it wide for the set to Bjorn Borg, so he takes the first set, 6-3, and we'll be back with the second set when we return to Willowbank. Welcome back to Prime's continuing coverage of the Champions Tour. This week we're in Mashpee, Massachusetts at the Willow Bend Country Club for the Mentadent Champions. Capacity crowd, as always, for our championship final between Jimmy Connors and Bjorn Borg. Dwight Stones along with Leif Shiras and Coach Dennis Ralston. As we begin the second set, Borg, the first set winner, 6-3.
Game for Jimmy Connors' lead, don't you think? Because, you know, he looks a little fatigued to us up here, and he certainly doesn't want to go down an early break.
Great angle out of the court with it. Connors is talking to the crowd. He's
I'm doing good. How you feel?
Trying to keep himself loose. Get his breath.
Bjorn says, Jimmy asks him how he feels, and Bjorn says, I feel great.
Right on the line.
It's a great lob. Here's a terrific lob. Big overhead down the middle. Jimmy gets this one back, but he's not going to get this one back. Winner.
Ace number three for Connors, and he holds in the first game of the second set. And we'll be back with more when we return. It's brought to you by Metadent, the baking soda and peroxide toothpaste with fluoride. By PowerStick, PowerStick offers more odor fighters than ever before. By Corel Corporation, makers of Corel Draw, the world's best graphics software. And by Conair, makers of family fitness and personal care appliances. And we've had a great time here this week on Cape Cod, Mashpee, Massachusetts, at the Willow Bend Country Club. The sixth stop on the Champions Tour, the Metadent Champions, Dwight Stones along with Leif Shiras and Dennis Ralston were in the middle of the second set. Borg taking the first set 6-3. They're on serve in the second. There's been a break apiece here in the second set with Borg serving up 2-1. Excuse me. Connors up 2-1. Big serve by Borg. Crucial for him to break back in that third game because Connors can get on a roll. Borg, I'm sure, would love to try to finish him off his great sets.
It's a rare thing to see Connors miss a backhand, really, without being pressured.
So Borg holds, and they're tied here in the second set, 2-apiece.
Well, Borg really gets a good rhythm when he gets that first serve in. Really sets the tempo for every point.
Hit it.
Oh, Borg really just dinking the ball back in the court.
Oh.
The wind in a bit of a lull just then. And Borg getting used to being able to hit out into the wind that's blowing from Connor's west end of the court towards Borg's east.
Giving Jimmy a little help here, you know, in this game. He's, those free points, those easy points are going to help Connors, because in a match like this, you go through three or four wins. Jimmy's such a competitor, you just can't count him out. Let those opportunities slip by. He hits a great shot here, and Jimmy makes a desperate get. And look at this. Oh, I'm going to make this one.
So Connors holds here in the fifth game of the second set. They're on serve. Borg ahead one set to love, and Connors 3-2. To the Mentident champions on Cape Cod. Here's the rest of the tour as it shapes up this year. Columbus, Ohio next week. Then Seattle, Washington in the middle of September. We'll be back on with you on Prime with in Hilton Head, South Carolina that first weekend in October. Then it's on to Los Angeles in the middle of October. And then the Champions Masters, January 17 through 22 in Las Vegas, Nevada. And that's where the winner of the singles will win $100,000. We're in the middle of the second set. Borg winning the first set, 6-3. They're on serve. But Connors leading 3-2 here in the second. Dwight Stones along with Lee Shiras and Dennis Ralston. Dennis, now the new director of tennis at the Broadmoor Hotel in Colorado Springs. I think that would be a good site for one of these tour events, don't you, Dennis?
Well, we're certainly interested in having one of these events there. Players are all cooperative, they work hard, they're all great players, so we're going to talk to the head guys here and see, maybe we can get these guys up at Colorado Springs, 6,500 feet.
I believe we go there, won't we?
In an instant.
Oh, it's a beautiful place, and building a great tennis facility, and it used to be mainly golf there, so we're going to try and get some tennis events, and this would be a great event for us.
Also pretty famous. Great figure skaters and figure skating coaches, as well as the Olympic Training Center in Colorado Springs. A lot of sports activities happening in that part of the country.
A lot of good fishing, too.
There you go. Here in the sixth game with Borg serving, down 30-40.
Pretty good point. You don't see him at the net that often, but he forced Jimmy to hit a tough running pass. But a couple of unforced errors in that game got him into trouble, and now Connors is back in this set, back in the match, excuse me.
Connors broke Borg earlier in the set. Borg broke right back.
Please reach up today, sometime before it's over.
Wild forehand by Borg.
about the little topspin that he hits, but boy, can he hit the ball flat when he wants to.
Bjorn at the net again, and Jimmy just nails his backhand. Can go anywhere, goes behind Bjorn. That was set up by a great backhand, just drilled it 2 inches over the net. Leaf, is this the critical seventh game?
Again, the seventh game looms.
Yeah. Ace number five for Jimmy Connors.
And the way Connors is attacking Borg when Borg's at the net is really a good lesson for a lot of players. You know, you don't have to win it on that first shot. You know, you can hit one shot to set up another one. Connors does that well. He keeps that first shot down low.
So Connors holds and leads 5-2 in this second set after Borg taking the first. Back to Willow Bend Country Club in Mashpee, Massachusetts for Prime's continuing coverage of the Champions Tour. This week, the Mentadent Champions. And this is the big final. Bjorn Borg versus Jimmy Connors. Borg winning the first set 6-3, but now down a break in the second set. Saving with Connors leading 5-2. Major factor in this match from the beginning, gusting up to 15 or 20 miles per hour at times. Borg's suddenly losing more points at the net than he's winning. About an hour old. Connors seems to have gotten his second win after looking very fatigued near the end of the first set.
Bjorn having some trouble holding on to his racket on that serve. It's the humidity's very high. Unforced errors by the sets, and Jimmy's really cut down on his unforced errors in this second set. On the other hand, Bjorn Borg, two more.
That total for Borg, twice his total from yesterday against Creek. Almost flawless against Johan Creek in the semifinal. Borg holds in this eighth game, but Connors still leads, up a break, 5-3.
Looks like Jimmy's gonna need a new shirt here. I'd say, Leaf, this is the critical game of the match right here for both players.
Connors really has to close it out now, and to have a chance in the third, even should this second go any longer, it would certainly tax him unduly. He really has to close it out now. Save some energy for that third set.
Borg attacking a second serve. Good return of serve and moving in. Jimmy just not able to move to get in position.
I think this wind has really cut into Jimmy's second serve, and Borg has attacked it a lot today. When the ball's short, Borg has just run around and cracked that forehand and attacked.
Young.
Connor's one of the great closers in the game, but we saw last week in New York in that third set, took him 10 championship points. Borg playing like he was at Wimbledon in the late 70s against Connors. Eight consecutive. And a rare lob on this windy day.
Jimmy still has some doubles left, too, after this singles final.
Good look at Patty Connors on the left.
With two set points here to close out the second set. Forcing what I think we all probably already knew would be a three-set match. And a nice save there by Borg.
40-30.
Connors with a good deep volley. Borg had the answer.
Well, I think Jimmy figured that that set was his.
You're sure it fits.
Borg will get a second ball here to try and get to deuce.
Baseline too, a tremendous angle.
Connors comes in on a great approach, and I think he's amazed that Borg tried the one-hander. Normally hits with two. There's the one-handed backhand that you seldom see from Bjorn Borg.
It's like a changeup.
Save two set points.
But that one just too good by Connors. Set point number three for Jimmy. And ace number six for Jimmy Connors closes out the second set. So they've each won one, 6-3. We'll be back with the deciding set when we return. Welcome back to Mashpee, Massachusetts, out on Cape Cod. Prime's coverage of the Champions Tour continues. Here, the Mentadent Champions, presented by Power Stick. And we are deadlocked, one set apiece for Jimmy Connors and Bjorn Borg, each by the score of 6-3. Dwight Stones, along with Leif Shiras and Dennis Ralston, bringing you this great match. Another classic duel between the Super Swede and the Junkyard Dog. And as we saw last week in New York, anything can happen. We've seen some great points this week here in Cape Cod from both of these players. And now we go to the third and deciding set. Jimmy Connors having won all five of the previous stops on this inaugural Champions Tour. And Bjorn Borg getting better and better each week. Having no problem cruising into the final this week, as did Jimmy. And this, as they say, ladies and gentlemen, is it. Bjorn Borg will begin serving in this third set.
Leaf, you still like your pick?
I like it. I think Jimmy's got a new shirt on. He's a bit refreshed. Sometimes you play through a tired period and you get that second wind going. Jimmy looks fresher than he did.
Yeah, I like your pick too.
It's a real manly racket.
The picks in the booth this week are Stones and Ralston going with Borg and Shiras going with Connors.
Oh.
like a winning approach shot, Borg just whips this down the line. He's got Borg stretched out in this deep approach, and watch this flick of the wrist. What a passing shot. See, Jimmy knows it's coming here. Dirty love. Borg serving, first game of the third set.
That Borg forehand just long on the baseline. Those easy points, he gets a lot of good first serves in. Ace number five for Bjorn Borg to win the first game of the third set. And we'll be back with more when we come back to Willow Bend Country Club. Look at the career singles titles list. Jimmy Connors well ahead at 109. Yvonne Lendl, who will probably join this tour next year as he turns 35, has 95 titles, and McEnroe way back at 77. He'll also be eligible for the Champions Tour in 1995. Jimmy Connors and Bjorn Borg remain on serve here in the third set, so we pick it up with Borg leading 3-2. Borg a little too ambitious on that return. He's had some success attacking the second serve, but critical now. You get the feeling that one break is going to make the difference here, deciding this match. On serve, Borg leading 3-2 in the third set.
Dwight, I think too, though, that the conditions, you know, are so tough down there. The balls that look like easy shots, there's nothing easy with that wind swirling. Bad bounces on the court. The miss hits.
To that equation, we've seen Borg lose his racket three different times, cracked two frames, lost a string. Both athletes now taking their time between points. Connors famous for taking probably more time than many, focusing on exactly what he needs to do, catching a little of a second wind.
I think he needs a smaller shirt. To see from where we are, but it looks to me, well, can't tell. Yes, no, I call it good.
Clearly out.
What do you think of that overrule, Leaf? Do you like that?
Well, it was in favor of my man, Connors, right now.
So you like it?
I thought it was a good, fair overrule. Plus, Jimmy's right on that line. If he saw it good, I'm sure he'd give it to Bjorny.
What a lot. Great approach by Connors. Now we see the famous Bjorn Borg topspin lob.
All the more impressive in these conditions, the wind gusting right about the moment he made that lob.
Yep.
There's a patented two-hander.
All of a sudden, it seems like these guys have upped the level a little bit. Look at this passing shot off a good approach by Borg. 3-all, 15-all.
Well, he hit that approach shot very deep, but it was also very high. And that gave Connors that angle down and away.
Active on that baseline, caught him standing around during three or four of those exchanges. Big point for Borg, down 15-30, comes up with his sixth ace of the match against Connor's seven aces.
Now Jimmy knew that he just, you know, it wasn't that the serve was so fast, he just didn't move for it. And, he let one get by him, 30-all.
Drop volley, you've got to open up the racket face and take pace off the ball. So you almost pull the racket off the ball as it hits your frame.
Pretty gutsy shot at 30-all, 3-all in the third set.
He's playing confidently.
Serve 4-3 for Borg in the third set. It's heating up. Borg back onto the court after a little break. And some of Champions Tour elite in the player's box. Johan Kriek in the middle of the screen. Roscoe Tanner a little bit to his right. Mel Purcell. And rocker Eddie Money. Mel Purcell there in the glasses, and Eddie Money there with his hand on his chin, enjoying the tennis here at the Willow Bend Country Club. And it's starting to get crunch time, folks. One set apiece on serve. Connor serving to Borg, 3-4. The wind taking a little bit of a break for this moment, but it's been swirling and gusting all afternoon long. Cyrus and Dennis Ralston bringing you here the action here on Prime. Sixth stop of the Champions Tour. Connors having won the five previous stops, but he's got all he can handle right here with Bjorn Borg. The third time they've met in the finals on the tour. Connors meeting Kriek three times as well, winning all three of those meetings, and Connors winning the previous two meetings against Borg, including last week at Westchester Country Club in New York. An exciting three-set match that Connors prevailed in, 6-4 in the third.
Oh!
up. Connor's on the side where the wind is blowing into his face, upwards of 15 miles per hour, making that toss very difficult.
Well, as long as Borg keeps that ball in the back part of the court, he can get away with that soft chip, but anytime it falls short, Connors is going to come in and eat it for lunch.
Here, but he's very close to the net. Really wasn't that great a lob, but just the Borg was just too close, and he gets ready, he's in trouble. Wynn holds it up. Connors holds to make the score 4-all, third set.
Gee, Borg disappointed me a little bit. I know Swedes can jump better than that.
Well, he won't be on the basketball team.
Still looks real tired, but he competes. He never gives up.
Yeah, I think both of the guys are a bit tired after a long week of tennis, but I think it shows in that they want to play shorter points, you know. Both guys are attacking now, trying to close out the points perhaps a shot or two earlier than they would if they were completely fresh.
Third set, a huge game for both players. If Borg can hold, he's in a hugely advantageous position, but if Connors were to break him here, it'd probably be it.
Serve really crossed Jimmy up. He wasn't sure whether to play it on the forehand or the backhand. It got into his body.
Stroke. He took a little bit of a swing at that one and dropped it right on the line. 40-15.
Great serve and volley by Bjorn Borg.
So Borg takes the ninth game of the third set. He leads 5-4. And we'll be back with more of the Metadent Champions right after this. Continuing coverage of the Champions Tour this week in Mashpee, Massachusetts for the Metadent Champions. There's Patty Connors, wife of Jimmy. And we have got a hot one here. One set apiece. Connors versus Borg. Connors serving, Borg leading 5-4. Dwight Stones, Lee Sharp, and Dennis Ralston bringing in the action. And Connors has never lost in 5 previous stops on the Champions Tour. Ralston and Stones picking Borg. Shivers picking Connors. The wind, the humidity, the heat, all factors this entire week. Both Connors and Borg getting to the final in straight set victories in the quarters and the semis. Connors the number one seed, Borg the number three seed. This their third meeting in the finals on the Champions Tour. Classic Borg-Connors battle. We've seen everything from these two players.
Borg is just content here to put some balls back into play, and I really think he has an opportunity here to be a little more aggressive, perhaps, go after the win.
Well, when you're up, normally with you know, up a game lead and the other guy serving, it's a good idea to take some chances to do something. Not very close on that passing shot.
Well, as we get down to these tense last moments, you certainly want your level of play to be right there then. But Borg has really played a sloppy game here. That's a bit better.
Borg's the kind of player, though, that can run off a bunch of points in a row, and even 40 love, Jimmy can't afford to relax.
We saw examples of that last week when Borg saved 9 match points against Connors in the third set on his own serve and on Connors' serve.
A little debris coming across the court. From 40 love, and Jimmy taking a lot of time here. Very big point.
Got time, and he sets up. Look at that beautiful shoulder turn. Tries to drive this one a little flatter. He knows how much that one meant. Would have pulled him within 2 points of the match. But instead, it's 5-all. And he's serving now downwind, so the pressure now back on his shoulders. Giving up a lot of real estate. He's very deep in the court. Connors handles that nice angle volley. Show he's ready.
This is the furthest that Jimmy Connors has been pushed into any match during the Champions Tour. Borg last week, 6-4 in the third.
This might be the first time Jimmy's been ahead in this match, too. And when he gets ahead, he pounces normally.
Set, which is saying something for both these players. With this wind, for there only to be 2 double faults in the match, Connors has suffered none. And Connors ahead of Borg 7-6. Big, big point in the match for Connors. Triple breaker against Borg.
Oh.
time behind him. Tough to gauge those lobs, and Borg able to save one. Break point. Still one more break point to save. Graphic tells it all. It's crunch time. It all comes down to this. Connors up a break, leading 6-5 in the third set against Bjorn Borg. The wind's gusting upwards of 15 miles an hour, blowing in his face as he has the match on his racket.
In this match, Leaf.
Connors now with a nice chance here. Borg again, a couple of loose arrows have really undone him. Well, and tough conditions too today, so he's come through a lot.
Triple championship point for Connors. Consecutive time on the Champions Tour, Jimmy Connors emerges victorious in a final. And we'll be back with more when we return to Willow Bend Country Club right after this. And for the winner's presentation, let's go down to the executive director of the Champions Tour, Henry Bren.
Henry Bren, executive producer of the Champions Tour.
Cape Cod is a great place to host a great tournament like this. Tremendous energy goes into producing an event like this. I'd like to first thank all the volunteers, over 100 of them. Laura Granito and her terrific staff, Craig Fleming and our family here at Willow Bend, and not to mention, of course, the 150% effort put in by the players. I'd like to introduce Mr. David Southworth, Managing Director of the Willow Bend Corporation.
responsible event. Thank, obviously, the champions of the tour, all corporate sponsors that have supported this event, the Wimbledon membership, the volunteers, and, of course, the people of Cape Cod. We hope this is the first of many, and we look forward to next year. Congratulations.
I present the final check, McNeil Silverman, wing manager for U.S. News World Report, and Marianne Summers, brand manager for Power.
On behalf of the U.S. News World Report and Power, we want to thank all the folks at Willow Bands, Jimmy Connors, and the players. It was an absolutely fantastic week, and we look forward to being back next year.
Congratulations to Jimmy Connors. He prevails once again in a classic.